G'day everybody, welcome to another Affinity Photo tutorial. This week we're going to do this photo collage that you can see on the screen here now. We're going to use five different photos and we're going to clip these photos to these shapes here. I'm going to show you two different ways that you can clip these photos inside of the shapes here. So as usual, let's get started. We're going to start off by coming up here to File and New. And the one I'm going to use is just this template here, 1080 by 720. I'm going to make sure that the orientation is landscape and just click on create. Make that a little bit smaller with my command minus. Come down here to new pixel layer down here and I'm going to fill that pixel layer with black. So I'm going to get my fill tool here, flood fill tool, and flood that with black. So we've just got this black pixel layer here. Now to make the shape I'm going to use is this trapezoid tool here. So I'm going to click on that. I'm going to make sure that I'm in white here because I want to draw this shape in white. And I'm just going to drag out that shape. I'm going to come up here to my move tool. I'm going to move that tool right in the middle. We'll see that green line when we've hit the middle and just click it into the middle there. Make sure you've got snapping turned on because that makes it a little bit easier. Going to drag the shape down to this ruler line here, 600. So down to 600 over here. So I've got that size 600 and I'm going to drag this out until I hit 380. So you can see on the screen there and I just want it to be 380. Just like that. Okay, that's good. Now I want five of these shapes. So I'm just going to make sure that I'm on this layer here. And I'm just going to go Command J four more times. So 1, 2, 3, 4. On the top one here, I'm just going to drag that all the way down to the end here. And another one all the way down to the end here. Snapping it into place. One here and one here. Okay, so we've got our five shapes. Now let's put them in order. So let's click on this shape here. That's number one. So let's just name that number one and hit enter. Let's click on the second one here. We'll need to move this one up and we'll name that one number two. Click on the third one and let's move that up and let's name that number three and so on. The fourth one, move that up, double click, enter. Fifth one is already in place. Fifth and enter. Okay, so we've got them all in place. This middle one here, I'm going to come up to arrange and flip vertically. I'm going to do the same with these two end ones, arrange and flip vertically, and the end one here, arrange and flip vertically. Got all our shapes in place. If you need to move any, just feel free to move them. Make sure you're on your move tool if you need to move them at all. Not looking too bad. We've got our one in the middle and they're all snapping in place quite nicely. So let's get our photographs inside. Now there's two different ways that you can get a photo clipped inside of a shape. Let's go to our first photo and hit Command C on our keyboard. Let's go back to our shapes here. So we can just go Command V to resize the photo. So I'm just going to drop that down a little bit in size with my command minus and let's just resize that photo till it's a reasonable size and then command zero to get that back. Now to get this photo inside of this shape, we can grab the photo here up here on this side and we can drag it down and move it to the right and that will place it inside the shape and we can move that shape around. Just remember, if you're clicked on the trapezoid, you can't move it, it's locked in. But if we click on the photo that we have just clipped to this shape, we can now move our picture around and place it into the shape where we want to see it. So that looks good at the moment. We can always move it around a little bit later. But on the second one, let's collapse that one. We'll show you the other way now. On the second shape here, we'll come to our next picture. Again, Command C, come back to our shapes. And on this way, the second way to do this is come up to Edit, and come up to here to paste inside. So that does the same thing as well. So let's just resize this one till we get the spot where we think it's going to look good. Okay, what I'm going to try and do on all these photos is line up the horizons. So we've got all our horizons in the same way. So you can use your arrow keys up and down to get those horizons sort of matched up a little bit. make sure that we're covering that whole shape. We can always make that a little bit bigger and just use our arrow key to get that horizon sort of in the same line. So there we go. So our second picture, and then we just got to move on down the line. Number three, let's go to our third picture, Command C, back to our shapes, and let's go edit and paste inside again. And just a matter of resizing that picture again, so we've got it fitting inside that shape nicely. And again, we want to line up those horizons with the sun in the middle there. So I'm just going to drag out and keep moving that across, and then I'd have to make it a bit bigger. Move the sun into that spot and then just move that down with my arrow key to line up those horizons. There we go. So we're going to do the same with the next two photos. So our next photo is this one. So Command C, back to our shapes, edit, paste inside. I'll speed this up a bit so you don't have to go through looking at the whole lot of these shapes going in. Okay, I've got all my pictures inside my shapes now, so I'm going to click on the top layer, holding my shift down and click on the fifth layer here, and Command G to group all of those pictures together. What I'm going to do now, open these up again, I'm going to come down here to FX, Layer Effects, and click on Layer Effects. I'm going to click on Outline, I'm going to make my outline line white because I'm on a black background. I'm just going to turn that up all the way to white. And on the radius here, I'm just going to move the radius up until I can start seeing that white line come around my shape there. That looks pretty good. Okay, I'm going to click off the layer effects now. And on that trapezoid, this first one, I'm just going to go Command C. And then on the second one, we can come up here to edit. And we've got this paste FX. So we're just going to paste the effect on each of these layers. So edit, paste FX. Just on each of these layers here, we don't have to go into the FX to do it for everyone. So edit and paste just the FX. So now we've got those white lines behind all of our shapes. Okay, let's collapse that and come back to our group. Let's go Command J. And on this group layer here, let's come up to Arrange and Flip Vertical. And let's move this one down to the bottom. I'm going to leave a small black space in between both of them here. So on that group there, I'm going to change the opacity and take the opacity down quite a bit, probably to about 15, just so we can just see it there. And there we go. We've got our photo collage with five different photos in our shape. We've used two different ways to get those pictures into the shapes. And as I said, if you remember, if we click on the group here, and if we want to move one of these pictures, say we want to move the picture on number one, have to make sure that we open up the shape, come to the background picture, and now we can move our photo around wherever we like in that shape. So there we go, everybody. This is the photo collage using shapes and five different photos. You can let your imagination run wild with this one. You don't actually have to use just the shapes. I've done this one here with letters. So if you're going to use the letters, just make sure that once you've created the letter that you rasterize it into a pixel layer so then you can get the photo pasted inside or clipped inside. And you can get really creative and make your own shapes if you like. I'll show you how to do that. We'll just create a new document here. Create, doesn't really matter at the moment. Let's just make a new pixel layer. Fill that with black. Okay, grab your pen tool. Create whatever shape you like, just holding shift down to make that a straight line. And you can start getting really imaginative with your shapes. Come up here to fill, swatches, fill that with white. We do have to make sure that we rasterize this layer now, so let's rasterize it. And then you can treat it just as a shape. Let's click on our Move tool. We've got a shape. Come over to a picture. Command C. Back to the shape that we've just created. Edit and paste inside. And it does exactly the same thing as what we did earlier with our other shapes. So as you can see, you can just use your imagination and create whatever shape you want, and also use your letters and create some really interesting art. So there we go, everybody. I hope you've enjoyed this week's tutorial. If you have, please give me a thumbs up. Please consider subscribing to my channel. And until next time, I'll say to you, Stay well, stay safe, and I'll see you in my next video.